By now you should be familiar with whole numbers. They are numbers without fractions. They are also known as counting numbers. Sometimes you want to refer to the parts of an object. Have you ever had to count, measure, or divide a part of something, like a pizza or a cake? That's when you'll need to use fractions. Let's dive a little deeper. A fraction is a number that represents a part of a whole. When you say things like half or thirds, that is a fraction that represents part of a whole. Think about a pizza. How do you share a pizza? Normally, you'd cut it up into parts or slices. Because we're dealing with parts, we can represent this with a fraction. There are two parts to a fraction. The number on the bottom is the denominator. A denominator tells the total number of equal parts or groups into which the whole or group has been divided. Pizzas are typically cut into 8 equal slices, so in this case, our denominator is 8. There are 8 slices total in our example. So what's the top number of our fraction? The number on top is known as the numerator. The numerator counts how many equal parts are being described. Say you want to make sure you get 2 slices of that pizza. You are describing the 2 slices that you are going to take, so that 2 is our numerator. So when we want to talk about how much of the pizza you took, you would represent this as the fraction 2/8. As you can see in the example, 2 of the 8 slices are colored. In our example, this is 2, since we are describing the number of slices you took. Fractions may seem intimidating at first glance, but with the right vocabulary, they're a piece of cake.